My name is Matthias Wilbold. I'm an isotope geochemist working at the Department of Isotope Geology at the University of Göttingen. The research of our group focuses on the evolution of the early Earth and how it transformed into an habitable planet. So rocks basically consist of most of the elements you find in the periodic table, apart from, for instance, the volatile elements. But we are interested in one specific element that normally occurs at ppm levels, so parts per million levels, so really low concentrations. And in order to be able to measure these elements or the isotopic composition of these elements, we need to isolate them from almost 99.999% of the rock matrix. And that's quite a challenge. And in order to do that, we dissolve the rocks using very strong acids and then process the samples in so-called clean laboratories or clean room laboratories that have filtered air running through them, overpressured. So we have a rather wide range of instruments, mass spectrometers in particular, that all give us the ability to look at different things, basically. Some of them, for instance, the Neptune Plus gives us the ability to measure high precision isotope ratios of most of the elements of the periodic table. The same we can do with the Triton, which is a thermal ionization mass spectrometer, which is very good for some elements, in particular those that have interferences on them that we can't get rid of in plasma mass spectrometers like the Neptune Plus. So these are our two workhorses to measure high precision isotope ratios. But we also have other mass spectrometers like the ICAP or the Element 2, which give us the ability to measure concentration data at very high accuracy and also precision. So with these isotope ratios, we can do different things. One major application is to determine the age of these rocks, which is very important. If we study processes that occurred on the early Earth, it's also very important to know when these processes occurred. So age information is very important for us. The second major thing we can learn from these isotope ratios are actual processes. On Earth, there are a huge range of different geological processes. For instance, we have subduction zones where plates are being subducted or transferred back into the mantle. So continental crusts or oceanic crusts transferred back into the mantle. We have mantle convection going on. We have crust formation processes. And all these processes that occurred on Earth today, but also on the early Earth, leave their mark in their isotope ratios.